These are the first images from inside the Pentagon. Total devastation. 124 lives lost when the hijacked plane slammed into the building. An office clock stopped at the exact time of impact. Poignant signs everywhere of a once vibrant workplace. A pair of glasses left on a desk. A jar of candy next to a computer. But the Pentagon says it could have been worse if the area had not recently been renovated.
And what's holding up this whole portion of the building still, when the initial blast occurred, incident occurred, is those steel columns that we put in, okay? Had it not been for that, we would have had a much larger collapse and perhaps many more casualties.
At Camp David, President Bush with top security advisors, including the vice president. The commander-in-chief ordered U.S. troops to get ready for war and braced Americans for a long, difficult assault against terrorists.
This act will not stand. We will find those who did it. We will smoke them out of their holes. We will get them running. And we'll bring them to justice.
But first, the nation is burying the dead. A memorial service this morning for TV commentator Barbara Olson, wife of the Solicitor General, one of the passengers on the hijacked plane that slammed into the Pentagon. In Maryland, an overflow crowd packs another memorial service for an elementary school teacher who was also a passenger. James Debonair was taking his student on a field trip.
Last words was, love you, I'll talk to you when I get back.
While the nation's airports are slowly resuming business following the terrorist attacks, many people are scared to fly, and it's having a ripple effect. Continental Airlines, the nation's fifth largest, has cut its flight schedule by 20%, laying off 12,000 employees.